Hey guys, and welcome to my new video. I'm the creator of the game called Snappy Mouse Run, and in the last video I showed you how to set up your reference images in Blender 2.8. And in this video I will talk about the layout and how everything works together before we go into the actual 3D modeling. Why? Because I can imagine that people get confused when searching for specific options, especially when they are not paying attention in which mode they are currently in. And when you know how everything works together, you kind of know where you can expect some of the options to be. I will just collapse the view so we have a clean workspace. Again, you can create or collapse views by dragging on the view corners. So, a quick overview. What we have? This is our 3D viewport where you can see your active scene. Your scene you can select over here, so this is our active scene. On the right you have your outlier with your object hierarchy and collections, and under the outlier we have your properties. Let's first talk about in which mode we are currently in. We are currently in object mode, what you can see by this drop down over here. And you can imagine object mode like a top level selection mode where you can select your objects either in the scene or in the outlier. And here you can also manage your objects and manage your collections. You can also multi-select objects like this. And you can tell the object is selected by the encirclement, by the icon encirclement, and not by the row highlight. So don't get confused by the row highlight, because in this case only the camera, cube and light are selected and the side image is not selected. So pay attention to the encirclement. In the object mode you can only change basic object properties like location, rotation, scale, and maybe parent an object to another object, and that's basically it. You cannot do much more in object mode. Let's just see what we have in the viewport. In the viewport on the left we have our toolbar with active tool, and you can toggle the toolbar by pressing T on your keyboard. On the right you can toggle the numbers panel by pressing N on your keyboard, and the numbers panel is just a combination of object settings, active tool settings and some view settings. Personally, I find only the view settings useful in the view tab, because the tool and the item settings you can also change under your properties with even more options available. That's why I only occasionally use the view settings and I just ignore the other two tabs. Also in the viewport we have our top bar. We'll talk about it a bit later, but if you're wondering why your top bar is at the bottom of the viewport, you can easily toggle it by right click on it, header, and flip to bottom. And also you can do header flip to top, so it's on the top. No magic there. If we again look at our toolbar, here we have the object mode tools available, and some are common for some other modes like the move, rotate and scale with the corresponding keyboard bindings, G for move, R for rotate and S for scale. Remember those shortcuts because you will use them all the time in Blender. Now let's see how everything works together. Let's just select an object in the viewport. We see in the outlier only the cube is selected because the cube has the encirclement. Let's just remove the highlight by pressing in the blank. And with our active scale tool selected at the moment, we can go to our numbers panel where we can see the active tool settings. The same we can also see in our properties under active tool. Also the selected object options we can see in the numbers panel under item top. These are location, rotation and scale. And the same options we can also see in the properties under object tab, with even more options available. And that's exactly the reason why I don't use the numbers panel that often, because I have all the properties over here with even more options, for instance parenting. So let's just close our numbers panel by pressing N on your keyboard, and let's look at our properties again. The first tab is the active tool tab, where you can see your active tool as said earlier. Then you have five tabs that are not really related to your selected object. We will cover them in some later video. And then there is the object tab. As said earlier, here you can change your basic object settings. These are common settings for all objects, so you will find the same settings on other objects, for instance camera, cube and light, or even image. And the more object specific options you can find under the object data tab. And you can tell this is the object data tab because it has the same image as the selected item in the outlier. Why are there two tabs in your properties with the object settings? If you are maybe familiar with object-oriented programming, then you can imagine the object tab as the base class and the object data tab as the derived class with more object-specific properties. Again, if I change the object, for instance, to cube, the object data image changes, so don't be confused by this. The object image is still the same, with the same set of settings. Another important thing that I want to talk about in this video is the object origin. That's this point over here, the orange one. So if we move the object by pressing G on your keyboard and drag them around, you see the orange dot moves and the location in the object tab has changed. Just press the left mouse button to release it. The object origin is important if you want to export the object to some other tool, for instance Unity, then we will have the object with an offset, and that's not actually what we want. We want that the object origin is at the world origin, and that's location 000. Another thing I want to talk about is this 3D cursor in the middle of the scene. You can check the 3D cursor position by opening the numbers panel by pressing N on your keyboard and going to your views tab. So here you have your 3D cursor's location. You can change this location by pressing Shift on your keyboard and right-click somewhere in the scene. You see the 3D cursor jumps to this location, and the location also has changed in the view settings. Again, this is a 3D cursor. That means if we rotate the view around, it's somewhere in the scene. So we can place it anywhere we want, for instance here. Why this 3D cursor is important or useful, we will see in the next video. But for now, let's say you can do specific object modifications in relation to this 3D cursor in space. In our case, we will use it to place the object again back to the world's origin. Press 1 on your keyboard to get back to the front view. Zoom a bit in with your mouse wheel. Then we will make sure that our 3D cursor is at world origin by either changing the location in our view settings, or there is a shortcut by pressing Shift S on your keyboard and selecting cursor to world origin. And now we can press Shift S again and select selection to cursor. This means our selected object moves to 3D cursor position, and we see the object is again at 000 with its origin. Okay, thank you very much guys. That's it for this video. In the next video I will show you how to 3D model this object in the background image and also what this top bar is used for. If you want to see more content like this, give a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you again in the next video. Thank you. Bye.